Thank you for having me. I'm trying to beat the record. I have more slides. But let's jump into the topic. It was unbelievable. Barca was 3-0 in front. Nobody gave a penny on Liverpool. My heart was with Liverpool. And you saw it. I hope, is anybody here who didn't saw this game? Oh, I don't have the game with me. Please look it up. And Liverpool made a 4-0. It's unbelievable. You're a Liverpool fan? Hans is a Liverpool fan. That was the most important message, and everything else you can forget. I wanted to talk about deep learning. What's deep learning? It's intelligence from big data, or transferring data into knowledge. First, an overview. The big thing is artificial intelligence. We have an AI lab here. Within AI, there's a subtopic, it's learning, in this case, learning of machines, machine learning. And a subtopic of machine learning is deep learning. Deep learning is learning by the means of neural networks. Deep learning is old stuff. It's neural networks, their age is old. What changed? We have now fast computers, wow. And we have data, we have big data. And these two ingredients, data plus fast computers, made this revolution possible. It's unbelievable. These old guys now really perform good. It already started years ago by some mad guys. Don't tell you about this, guys. Here's the idea of deep learning. Why is it deep? Because you have a neural network. I should not go here, but I told you I will do it. I'm now doing what I'm told not to do, go in front of the slides. This is a neural network. It has different layers of representation. And the task is here, your face is here. You should say, what face is it? Is it Meinert Lukas or Alex Egiet? You have to separate them because it's from the rectorate. And it will automatically learn something. And in the first layer, it's learning edge detectors. The next layer, parts of faces, noses, eyebrows, or whatever. The next part, this next layer, this is the prototype faces. What is here completely different? There were professors, there were JKU professors spending many, many years, like 30 years, to coming up, what is the best edge detector? Bullshit, forget it. If you have enough data, the machines learn it automatically. And that's a new thing. You don't have to think what's good. You extract it from the data. And that's a new wave. That's what's going on now. If you look outside, if you have enough data, you can extract the information from data, but don't have to do it analytically. And it's impacting all fields. Physics, you will see more and more machine learning. Medicine, I don't see the medical guys, so skip this lecture. It will impact a lot of fields. This is, I don't go into the math, that's the basic idea. You have a training phase, you have a neural network. It should say, is it a dog, a cat, a raccoon? It was good for a dog, it was good for a cat, but raccoon it does wrong. You give some feedback about the errors, adjust here the neural network, especially the connecting weights, and that's the way you learn. That's a mathematical method called gradient descent. And then later you get a new dog thing, even a dog in the water, and the neural network analyzes this picture and says, yes, what I'm seeing is a dog. Perhaps you heard what was possible. AlphaGo has beaten Lee Sedol. But you have to know the community. The community said, okay, until Go, it's about Go, that's Go. Until an AI system, an artificial intelligence system, will beat the Go master, it will take 100 years, 50 years. And within 2 years, this prediction were obsolete. Now the systems are at a level of Go masters. Nobody thought about it. And even here, another thing. The guys from DeepMind Systems, the DeepMind guys, which also did AlphaGo. Alpha is, you can think where Alpha comes from, Alphabet, from the master company of Google, and DeepMind belongs to them. 4 hours putting a computer in the corner, and then you get out the computer, then it's the best chess engine existing on this world. And that's unbelievable, because Stockfish, I know the guys from Stockfish, you pay grandmasters and grandmasters for over 20 years to give their evaluation of the position and to teach the computer chess. Here, you put this guy in the corner, if you have enough compute power, after 4 hours, it learned everything humanity needed over 300-400 years to develop. Wow. A couple of examples. Deep learning in vision. Does it start? This is a cell phone. You put the cell phone to some object. Interesting. It can separate Pepsi from Coke. It's important in AES. And attachment Ford, because we're in this guy is blind, and he can see now with the cell phone, which is great. He puts his great phone, cell phone in front of an object, and the cell phone tells him what he's seeing. I go ahead. That style transfer also, no tone, which is correct. Here you get different styles, and it's overlaying the right-hand side. It's possible. So AI automatically sees what style it is, puts it over this online. We can do it online. We had a demonstration in ours, Electronica Center, perhaps you know this. Yes, that's a thing we can do. Perhaps another example. This is some politician, probably nobody knows him. This is a student, also nobody knows him. And look, he makes some faces. That was the original. And now this is what you always see on TV. What's on TV? Don't believe. Now we have AI systems. Who knows what you see on TV versus reality or not? Perhaps it's some student from JKU making things, and Sebastian Kurz is not doing these strange faces. And this is possible. It's also possible online these days. What else do we have? Speech and text. There comes long short-term memory in the game. It changed stuff in natural language processing and text processing, stuff like this. It's now in Amazon's Alexa's, Google Translate, stuff like this. I invented it once. Nobody, it was rejected. Who got the paper rejected? Be happy. Wait 20 years and you will be happy. You lucky guys, you got the paper rejected. There are some poor guys who never got the paper rejected. And later, it's used by all big IT companies. This guy, yeah, but we met this guy. He's not a good machine learner, but he's actually a nice guy. Facebook, okay, perhaps I should tell you something. All human knowledge is in text. Medical knowledge, law, and stuff like this. If we can build an AI who can understand text, we have access to all human knowledge because it's put down as text. We are not there, but Facebook and also Facebook guys are working on this. We want to have access to all human knowledge. Hey. Google transformed into a deep learning company, but we know this. For example, okay, Google, there's also they're using LSTM and stuff. It's here in the car for getting some song played. Amazon, they made a lot of money with my stuff. I didn't get a penny. Because what was so interesting for them is, if a French guy puts some product on the Amazon and he writes it in French, the guys in Austria, the guys in Germany, the guys in, don't know, England, do not understand it. But if you have automatic translation, you sell more. And this had a big impact. Automatic translation, they used it and they made money. I didn't get a penny. Yeah? but they made a huge money with it because you open the market. And you cannot put guys here to make this translation. It's a simple translation. What is this stuff you see on the picture? Alexa, you know, so you see for Alexa. Oh, this is okay. Apple was dead, but now it's alive again. We thought Apple will go from the market, but they put a lot of money in machine learning into AI. Now they are there again, in contrast to other companies which should vanish soon, like IBM. It's about Siri. They put it in the Siri thing. Now they're using some modern techniques, and probably Apple will be long on the market. Some applications, only a short overview. You heard perhaps about autonomous driving, AI techniques used for this, also here LSTM. Idea is here to use sequences. You know the stupid guys from Tesla and from Uber, they use only one frame only. They use the last frame, but here I made an example. You have a cyclist putting out the hand. What would you expect? Yeah, perhaps do the left hand, it's even more. And then I will make a left. Right. But you should memorize that the hand was out. Tesla and Uber, these guys only look at this picture, and then they're surprised because the cyclist now goes into the street. But living in sequences, living in time, this is much better. We are not so stupid in Europe. Attention, there's another stupid thing. What is doing the guys from Uber, everybody, analyzing this picture, analyzing this tree, where's the leaves, blah, blah, where's the trash can, stuff like this. Stupid. Stupid. You should do attention. If you know there's a traffic light, you want to look at the traffic light and see, is it red? If it's red, I can make a decision. I stop. But if I know how the trash can looks like, it doesn't help to make a decision. And that's right now. You need attention mechanisms in these systems. Look at the stuff, analyze the stuff, which helps you to make decisions. That is also what we did in the LIT project, to make a connection to that. I go ahead. Jensen put in his last conference a couple of things on. Now we have simulations, very high-quality simulations. You already mentioned it, Alex. This will come. We will simulate more and more, put the world on the computer, find something there. This is all simulated, actually, on a fast graphic card. What I want to show you is Sierra Neural Networks. That's a guy who produces pictures. This is a guy who says, is it simulated? Is it fake? Is it artificially made or is it real? That's a system. It's called Generative Adversarial Networks. It's very popular this day. And only this simple principle, to combine two networks. Only to combine two networks. I show you what's come out. This is the faces. Do you recognize these guys? Who does recognize somebody? You cannot recognize somebody because these faces do not exist. That was the AI thought, how could faces look like? These are new faces that do not exist. You also see some. I'm not allowed to go into it, but I go into it. And you see here, for example, sometimes the two eyes fit not to each other. There are shortcomings. You see it's not perfect, but it's quite good. It's like AI thinks faces look like. It's impressive. 10 years, 20 years ago, you wouldn't have believed this. But we can also say, like an AI thinks airplanes might look like. Here, like an AI thinks bottle could look like. Here, there's a giveaway, of course. It's about the bottle, it's not about the labeling of the bottle. It's not of, you see it automatically. That's not a real language. But quite impressive. I have only 20 minutes left. There are some giveaways, but from the bottle kind of view, even this, you perhaps you would even like to drink this. Like buses look like. Sometimes it went wrong. Like how bridges look like. Are the bridges? I don't see it. Cats. This doesn't exist. It's how the systems think it's cats. Whether this is a cat, I don't know. Sometimes it's really weird. This is a car. Yeah. Perhaps after a crash, I don't know. but it's only at least the generator could fool with this picture, so a discriminator. The discriminator cannot distinguish this from a real car, at least. Yes, yeah. Bicycles, bedrooms, finished. Thank you.